What has Dave Filoni revealed about the season 2 of The Mandalorian? Well, in this video, I review his recent interview with EW and I have some important points about the new Disney Plus documentary on the first season of The Mandalorian. So let's get right into it. And first up here, EW asked Filoni in the interview, "There are so many lingering Mandalorian questions, from why the Empire targeted Mandalore to why their tribalistic rules changed. To what degree will you bridge the gap with what we know from The Mandalorian?" "Those are really interesting questions and fascinating and valid," replied Filoni. "But I don't know if the job of this story is to bridge that. This story should be about what the characters need and what their wants are." I think this is a really important insight for fans because with the rumors of Ahsoka Tano showing up in the show, and maybe even Ezra and Sabine from Star Wars Rebels, many people, including myself, are thinking that the Mandalorian series would totally fill in details of how the Mandalorian people go from what we see in Rebels to what we see in The Mandalorian. But later in the interview, Filoni goes on to state, "There might be things that shade in certain directions. I'm sure people will see connections that I don't see. It wasn't like one of the primary goals." So again, Filoni reinforces here the idea that the story of the characters in The Mandalorian is their focus. They are not setting out to give us the history of the Mandalorian people and fill in those unknowns. And I mean, for me personally, it would be really cool to learn more about what actually happened to the Mandalorian people, but I'm glad to hear that the focus is on the characters at the present moment in the story. I do believe, however, that this means that we can rule out Sabine Wren being in season 2, because she certainly would know the history and take the time to share it with Din Djarin. So I think that's one of the major revelations that we can take away from this interview. But moving on here, EW also asked Filoni, "What can you tell us about your live action Ahsoka?" And Filoni states, "All those rumors. Over the years, people have always asked me about that character and potential live action possibilities. It's a real credit to the animation team and everybody that's been involved with her over the years to make a character that fans say, hey, that would be great. We would want to see that." And the debates that surround that. And I find it very interesting here that Dave mentions the debates that surround Ahsoka coming to live action. I believe Filoni is referring to the debate specifically about whether Ashley Eckstein should be the live action Ahsoka Tano. Certainly when the live action Ahsoka rumors were revealed, it was a debate that was raging all over the internet. So it's interesting that Filoni mentions that here. Though again, I don't think it's in any way an official confirmation that Ahsoka is actually in season 2. Dave Filoni does go on to state in the interview that the great thing about the character is that she's proved herself and earned her place among the Star Wars leads out there. So whatever the future holds, who knows? But for now, we'll get to see the ending of Clone Wars and see how that goes. And certainly it seems to be going fantastic, and looking at the success of the Siege of Mandalore story arc and the popularity of Ahsoka overall, Filoni's words about her earning a place among the Star Wars leads out there certainly makes me think we're going to see a lot more Ahsoka. But again, that's just me, a huge Ahsoka fan, reading a little too much into what Filoni's saying in this interview. Filoni also mentioned in the interview that season 2 of The Mandalorian has been a lot of fun. Maybe that's just me reacting to making it. Now that I have a year of it under my belt doing live action, and I need so much more experience. I wrote in the Clone Wars, experience outranks everything, and I'd need to get some. So it was a great learning experience, working with a great team of people, working with John. I've applied what I've learned into the second season to the best of my abilities, and I think everything is getting better and better, and everyone was energized from the reaction we got from the first season. We're looking forward to sharing it with everyone when we're finished. And personally, I'm really looking forward to the Disney Gallery, The Mandalorian, the behind the scenes of The Mandalorian Season 1. I think we're going to see a lot of what Dave Filoni has mentioned in this interview, just how well these directors work together, and how great a showrunner Jon Favreau is. Don't forget, by the way, that tomorrow on Star Wars Day, we will be getting the first Disney Gallery The Mandalorian episode. It'll debut 3 a.m. Eastern Standard Time in the U.S. And then, important to note, the next episode of the series will be shared on Disney Plus this Friday, May 8th. That's right, we get the finale of The Clone Wars and two episodes of The Mandalorian documentary all this week. It's a great time to be a Star Wars fan. Let me know what you think of all this in the comments below. As always, I'm Mike. Thanks for watching, and may the Force be with you.